A couple of videos ago, I couldn't use this 25mm tool to level my fixture plates. It was leaving pretty bad marks on my workpiece. These marks were the result of an out-of-trim spindle. This means that the spindle isn't 100% perpendicular to the machine bed. I made this cut design to illustrate the effect that the out-of-trim spindle has on the tool. In this first example, the tool is 100% perpendicular to the workpiece, and it only cuts with the therefore designed cutting edges. When the feet and speeds are also correct, the operation should result in a nice surface finish. In this second example, the spindle is out of trim, and the tool is cutting under an angle. You can clearly see that the tool is cutting deeper on the right side than on the left side. If we edit the drawing to the new position of the tool, we can see what the effect is on the surface finish. The spindle can be out of trim in both the X and the Y axis. To measure how much the spindle is out of trim, you need to buy or make a trim tool. I couldn't find anything that fit my spindle, so I built my own version from an 8mm strip aluminium, a small dial indicator and a broken end mill. Next up was creating a flat surface on my machine bed. One of the flattest things I had laying around was this cloth plate for my heated bed of my printer. In the y-axis, the glass bed was almost perfect, but in the x-axis, I measured a 0.2mm difference in height. By using two strips of A4 paper, I got it within 0.08mm, what is good enough for this first attempt. Now let's see if the custom trimming tool is going to work. If you would zero the indicator anywhere on the glass plate while the spindle is 100% perpendicular, the indicator would show the same measurement when rotating the trim tool. But if the spindle is out of trim, we would see the needle move when the tool is rotated. The X-axis is the shortest axis on my machine, and the Y-axis is the longest. So I call these adjustments to the spindle adjustments along the x-axis, and these adjustments are called adjustments along the y-axis. The position of the tramming tool is indicated by 12, 3, 6 and 9 o'clock. If we want to measure the position of the spindle along the y-axis, we zero the indicator at 9 o'clock. Then we rotate the tool 180 degrees and we measure the value at 3 o'clock. If we measure a positive value, we know that the spindle is tilted clockwise, and we have to adjust by rotating it counterclockwise. If we measure a negative value, we know that the spindle is tilted counterclockwise, and we have to adjust it by rotating it clockwise. The principle is the same for adjustment along the x-axis. Adjusting the spindle along the y-axis can be done by loosening the bolts of the spindle clamp and tapping it with a soft hammer. We make use of the spare room between the bolts and the spindle bracket to manipulate the position of the spindle. Adjustments along the x-axis can be done by placing shims between the spindle bracket and the machine frame. Placing shims on the top side will tilt the spindle clockwise, and placing shims on the bottom side will tilt the spindle counterclockwise. After lowering the tram tool on the glass bed, I zeroed the indicator at 4 o'clock. When I moved the tool around, the tip of the indicator was already floating a couple of millimeters in the air at 6 o'clock and at 3 o'clock. This indicated that the spindle was pretty far out of tram. Normally, I would start with correcting the spindle along the x-axis by placing the shims. If you start with correcting along the y-axis, you're going to have to do it twice. This is because you have to loosen the spindle bolts completely to place the shims, and this will mess up your alignment in the y-axis. In this case, the adjustment that had to be done along the x-axis was so large that I suspected it was going to cause some problem. So to be sure, I started with this axis first. I zeroed the indicator at 3 o'clock and measured about minus 1.2 millimeters at 9 o'clock. A small anti-clockwise adjustment with the hammer didn't seem to change anything. When loosening the spindle so far that I could adjust it by hand, the problem became clear. Even with the maximal possible adjustment, the tip of the indicator was still floating in the air. This meant there was not enough clearance between the holes in the spindle brackets and the Allen bolts that secure it to the machine frame. This had to be fixed before I could proceed. By placing a wooden block under the spindle, I made sure that I could safely detach it without putting too full weight on the bolts and the screw threads. I placed the spindle on a platform so I could safely work on it without damaging the cables or the cooling fluid lines. I didn't want to drill too much material away because there wasn't much left on the sides of the brackets. The original holes were 6.1 mm, so I decided to re-drill them to 7.5 mm. Some of the screw threads in my machine aren't made that well. I suspect that the manufacturer used a worn-out tool. I like to recut the threads with a high-quality tap of the same size, metric 6 in my case. This cleans up the threads and they feel like new afterwards. Also, the original black Allen bolts are from questionable quality. Every black Allen bolt I take out of the machine gets replaced with a high quality version. I also added some spacers on the spindle bolts because the holes of the brackets are almost the same size as the heads of the Allen bolts. After recalibrating the glass bed, I was curious to see if the larger clearance had solved the problem. I zeroed the dial at 3 o'clock and measured -0.6 mm at 9 o'clock. I corrected the spindle counterclockwise with 2 light taps. I re-zeroed the indicator at 9 o'clock and when I moved it to 3 o'clock I measured -0.1 mm. There was still some more room to tilt the bracket clockwise, so adjusting the last 1/10 of a millimeter wouldn't be a problem. Now we know that there's enough clearance between the spindle bracket and the bolts to do the Y adjustment, we have to start from the beginning with adjusting the X axis. As I already mentioned, the X axis rotation can be adjusted by placing shims between the bracket and the machine frame. But for minor adjustments, it's also possible to play with the tension of the top bolts and the bottom bolts of the spindle bracket. Loosening the top bolts a few degrees and fastening the bottom bolts will rotate the spindle clockwise. Doing this in the opposite way will rotate the spindle counterclockwise. After I made sure that all the bolts were fastened with the same amount of tension, I did the first measurement by zeroing the dial at 12 o'clock and rotating it counterclockwise. It reached its limit at +1.45 mm at 8 o'clock. This means that the spindle is tilted clockwise along the x-axis, and we have to adjust it counterclockwise by adding the shims on the bottom of the spindle bracket. I made 2 identical 0.8 mm shims by folding a small stroke of business card together. I placed the shims on both sides on the bottom of the spindle bracket. I pushed them as far in as possible until they hit the threads of the Allen bolts. After lightly fastening the 4 bolts, I zeroed the indicator at 6 o'clock and measured at 0.2 mm at 12 o'clock. I made a small clockwise correction by first loosening the top bolts a few degrees and then fastening the bottom bolts some more. Again, I zeroed at 6 o'clock and measured 0.12 mm at 12 o'clock. After redoing this previous step one more time, I finally got the indicator at 0. In total, I spent another 2 hours of measuring and adjusting until I finally got the spindle within 0.25 mm in both axes. With a hammer as adjustment tool, it was extremely difficult to do the fine adjustments. Even with the smallest step of the hammer, I overcorrected most of the times. Although the result of the first attempt wasn't perfect, it drastically improved the performance of the machine. Where the 25 mm tool gave a 0.3 mm mark before, it wasn't possible to measure it anymore in the new situation. I also found that cutting aluminium was much quieter than before, and the surface finish improved as well. The next time I'm going to trim the spindle, I would like to improve 2 things. First, I would like to buy or design a trimming tool that's more reliable than this first one. Secondly, I would like to make a system that makes it easier to do the fine adjustments. For example, along the Y-axis, something where 2 bolts can rotate the spindle in both directions. For adjustment along the x-axis, a system that makes it possible to adjust the shims by turning a screw in or out. If you have a suggestion for such a system, please leave a comment in the comment section below. If you are new to this channel and you like CNC, 3D printing, metalworking, Arduino projects and more tech stuff, consider subscribing by clicking the subscribe button. Thanks for watching, until next time.